Magandang araw mga kaibigan. We will try to understand today a concept in civil procedure. This is very important because without this, walang civil case na pwedeng ma-file sa mga courts. We will try to simplify the concept or principle of a cause of action. The rule 2 of the rules of civil procedure. Napakahalaga po ng cause of action mga kaibigan. Almost lahat ng civil action or cases ay dapat based sa cause of action. Ito ang rason kung bakit magfa-file ka ng kaso sa korte. As a matter of fact, in actual practice, isa sa mga ina-allege at dapat i-establish sa complaint or petition through allegations of ultimate facts ang cause of action ng clients mo. If you are for the defendant, one of the many things that you are going to check in the complaint ay kung may cause of action ba talaga ang plaintiff. Kasi kung wala, you can raise it as one of your special and affirmative defenses para maipa-dismiss ang kaso. Ang cause of action mga kaibigan under Section 2, Rule 2 ng Civil Procedure is the act or omission by which a party violates the right of another. At ibig sabihin po niyan is that may ginawa or may hindi ginawa ang isang tao or entity na naka-violate sa right ng isang tao or party. Cause of action. There are 3 essential elements of cause of action. Please remember po, essential elements. Kung wala ang isa sa tatlo or hindi kompleto ang tatlong essential elements, ay hindi raw matatawag na may cause of action or may existing na cause of action ang isang complaint or petition. Una, there is a legal right of the plaintiff. Pangalawa, a correlative obligation on the part of the defendant to respect that right of the plaintiff. Pangatlo, and finally, there is an act or omission on the part of the defendant which violates the right of the plaintiff. Simply stated mga kaibigan, una, may existing na karapatan or right ang complainant. Pangalawa, obligado po ang taong sinampahan ng kaso na irespeto ang nasabing karapatan. At panghuli, may ginawa ang defendant na hindi pagrespeto or may paglabag sa nasabing karapatan ng plaintiff. Now, in order to understand that, let us bring that concepts in a typical case. Example po, mga kaibigan. Let us say, pinautang mo yung kaibigan mo ng 10,000 pesos dahil gagamitin raw niya ang pera personally. At because law student ka, you made a written contract on December 25, 2019. To the effect, babayaran ng kaibigan mo ang 10,000 pesos na inutang niya on February 10, 2020 without interest. Now, pagdating ng February 10 or February 11, 2020, ay nagpadala ka ng demand letter because you intend to collect his indebtedness or the amount of 10,000 pesos from your friend. However, akalain mo he refused to pay. Pinaliwala ang demand letter mo. After that, you brought the matter to the barangay. And yet, wala pa rin nangyari at hindi ka nabayaran ng 10,000 pesos. February 14, 2020 na po mga kaibigan, Valentine's Day. Gagamitin mo sana yung pera na ipinahiram mo sa iyong kaibigan para ipang-date sa boyfriend or girlfriend mo. Unfortunately, dahil wala kang pera at hindi nagbayad yung kaibigan mo in the amount of 10,000 pesos, hindi kayo nakapag-date, nag-away kayo ng boyfriend or girlfriend mo, and worse, nakipag-break pa siya sa'yo. But that is beside the point, mga kaibigan. You now intend to file a collection suit or small claims in court to collect the amount of 10,000 pesos representing the indebtedness of your friend as the debtor from you, as the creditor. The question is, do you have a cause of action? Kung ikaw ay isang law student taking up civil procedure, your answer will be yes. Meron ka pong cause of action. Bakit? You have an existing right predicated on a contract. You are the creditor. You must be paid the amount of 10,000 pesos based on the contract on or before February 10, 2020. Yan po ang kasunduan. Second, the debtor, who happens to be your friend, has the correlative obligation to make good of his undertaking to pay you the amount of 10,000 pesos on or before February 10, 2020. He has to comply with the contract because he bound himself with the written agreements stated thereon. And finally, there was an act on the part of your friend debtor which violated your right as the creditor. That act, mga kaibigan, pertains to his failure to pay you the amount of 10,000 pesos on the agreed date based on the contract. In other words, there is a contractual breach on his part. Since complied na po ang tatlong elements, then and therefore, you can institute a complaint in court because you now have a cause of action. Kasi kung wala ka pang cause of action, you should never institute a complaint in court. That is now the meaning, simply, of a cause of action. However, Please remember po, in the example cited, if you intend to collect the amount of 10,000 pesos before February 10, 2020, you do not have yet a cause of action. If you are going to do that, it has not yet ripened into a justiciable controversy. Why? Because there is no invasion or violation yet of your right as the creditor by the debtor. Kasi wala pang violation. There is no act or omission yet which violated your right. Pagagalitan ka lang po ng korte, i-dismiss po ng korte ang case ninyo. Eh suppose for example, kapatid ka ng creditor. Yung kapatid mo ayaw mag-collect ng utang sa kaibigan niya. Then you learned about this, galit na galit ka kasi ayaw maningil ng kapatid mo sa umutang despite nag-lapse na yung period in the contract within which the debtor has to pay the amount of 10,000 pesos. Pero ang kapal talaga ng mukha ng umutang sa kapatid mo, ayaw pa rin magbayad. And because concerned ka, please remember that we are still in the concept of a cause of action. You take the initiative to institute a complaint in court without the knowledge of your sibling creditor. The question is, do you have a cause of action? The answer to that question will lead us to another concept, which is the right of action. Certainly, mga kaibigan, you cannot institute a case in court because you do not have the so-called right of action. Unless, of course, you are authorized by your brother or sister who is the creditor in this case. A right of action is distinguished from a cause of action in that it is a remedial right belonging to some person. A right of action is the right to presently enforce a cause of action in court. In the example given, mga kaibigan, wala kang right of action to enforce in court because you are a complete stranger to the contract of loan executed by your brother or sister and the debtor. The debtor, therefore, is not legally obligated under the contract to pay you. The cause of action which pertains to your sibling creditor does not necessarily extend to you, a third party, without his consent or authority. Otherwise, if you will insist, the complaint will be dismissed, either on the ground that the plaintiff has no personality to sue, or that the complaint fails to state a cause of action. Normally, if one has no personality to sue, the complaint is dismissible on the ground of failure to state a cause of action. This ground, of course, should never be confused with lack of cause of action. These are two separate animals, mga kaibigan. But we are going to discuss this and fully appreciate these two concepts when we touch and discuss Rule 16 of the Rules of Civil Procedure. Sinabi po natin kanina that you cannot go immediately to the court kung wala kang cause of action. Pero, there is an exception to the rule, mga kaibigan. You can file a petition for declaratory relief under Rule 63 of the Rules of Court, even if there is no actual breach yet or invasion of a right. The concept of a cause of action under ordinary civil actions does not strictly apply in special civil actions for declaratory relief because the latter presupposes that there has been no actual invasion or violation of the instruments involved or of rights arising thereunder. Yan po ang konsepto ng cause of action ayon po sa civil procedure. But I just would like to make some reservations about our discussion on that particular concept. Mas mabuti, mas mainam if babasahin po natin ang konseptong ito fully and completely sa aklat. So sa susunod na episode, sa mga law students and law advocates dyan, we will try to understand some concepts about sa batas sa pinakamadaling pamamaraan.